Before you delve into the intricacies of your goal swing to try and understand what the ball flights are that you're seeing, always understand that the way you get yourself set up, the grip, the posture, and other aspects in the way that you stand to the side of the ball will have a massive impact on what that ball flight will do when you get out onto the golf course. Now, the first thing you have to understand is that your grip is one of the main controlling factors of what happens to club face. And if your grip isn't what you need it to be, then the ball flights will suffer. For example, there are a lot of people who hit big hooks who have a very strong grip. So left hand a long way on top, right hand a long way underneath. And then the opposite is true of people who maybe hit a slice. You have a very weak grip. So left hand a little bit too much underneath the club and the right hand a little bit too much on the top. But there are alterations you can make with your wrist angles. So this isn't always the case. But if you are struggling with the troublesome ball flight, always check the grip first and understand that strong grips will generally close a club face to target and then a weak grip will generally open a club face to target. But there are other aspects in your swing that will cause other aspects in your setup that will cause changes in your swing. For example, if you are struggling with a slice, especially with your driver, which many golfers do struggle with, then generally your path is going to be moving to the left of your target line with the club face being open to that path and open to target, curving the ball off to the right-hand side. However, if you're getting yourself set up with a quite flat shoulder position, so your left shoulder isn't above your right, and then the shoulders are also open to the target, that's always going to encourage a swing which travels off to the left-hand side by too much. So if you're getting set up in this position, flat shoulders and then open, that's always going to be trying to cause the path to travel too far off to the left-hand side. The opposite is true. If you close the shoulders too much and tilt them too much away, that's going to be encouraging a path which is a long way to the right-hand side, a long way swinging up on the ball, which could cause that hook position. So if you are looking to change things within your ball flight, always start with your setup, always start with the basics and understand that you can change your ball flight very quickly by just adjusting what your body is doing at the address position.